Hello and welcome to Friday Features. I'm Heather Masters and today we're talking about something I know that I've really felt this week, and I know that I think most of us feel it one time or another, and that's the struggle to show up and do what needs to be done when we feel like we've either got nothing to give, we're feeling flat, we're feeling out of sorts, maybe we're feeling tired or even unwell. And maybe if you're feeling uninspired or overwhelmed or just plain tired, whatever it is that's going on, you know, we sometimes just have to tackle things and show up anyway. So we're going to tackle it together today and learn how to push through those moments when showing up feels like the hardest thing in the world. And I know that sometimes, you know, other people will say that it's not even appropriate to try and show up if the energy's not right or you're just not feeling it. But sometimes there are days when we just have to show up. And I didn't show up on Wednesday. I felt really flat this week about doing the lives because I've been questioning whether they're really adding any value to anyone. So, you know, I'm kind of in a reflective, contemplative mood around what content I'm putting out, what my focus is, what the purpose is, and whether these are adding value. And on that note, if you do think they're adding value, please do like and share and follow or subscribe, because it does help me keep going. It gives me some feedback, you know, put some feedback in the comments if these are helping you. So it's been a little bit about that and reflecting, as I say, on how I'm adding value and how I can add more value and show up in a bigger and better way. But in that process, I haven't felt like showing up. And it was interesting on Wednesday, which was Wednesday Woo Day. I actually spent a lot of the day working with Woo. I had an amazing Ho'oponopono session in the morning and a brilliant interview with a wonderful Woo lady, Kay Downey, for the Choosing Happy podcast, which I do, and you can find it choosinghappypodcast.com. And what was interesting about that is that I didn't feel that it was appropriate to share anything, even though I spent a whole day, as I say, working with the Woo. I didn't go live on Woo Wednesday, and I found that quite an interesting paradox, if you like. And I have been looking at what's stopping me from wanting to show up. I think sometimes that's a good place to start, but again, we don't want to get stuck in our stuff. So if you do have something that you need to show up for, then let's look at ways that you can change your mindset, make a different decision, and show up fully you and present. We've all heard the phrase that showing up is half the battle. And what does that really mean? Because it's easy to show up when you're feeling great, when you feel you've got that value to add, when you're full of ideas, you're feeling motivated. But when you, on those days you just don't feel it, how do you show up? Especially if you're questioning your value, your purpose, or your ability to contribute anything meaningful, which is where I've been this week. And I bet you've been there at times too. But here's the thing, showing up matters more than you think. Even when you don't feel at your best, your presence is powerful and consistency is key. So let's talk a little bit about the power of consistency. One of the, I think it's Matt Gray, says that if you don't show up 2 days in a row, if you like take over more than 2 days off, then you kind of lose that consistency, especially if you're on social media or you're trying to build a personal brand and an audience. It can really lose the momentum. And it's also about the energy behind consistency, putting that consistent energy out to the universe and letting it know that you are showing up, that you are wanting to contribute. So it also creates trust within yourself, within your unconscious mind, and it kind of overrides that negative voice. By showing up every time, you kind of dampen that negative voice that might be telling you not to show up. So even when you show up, even when you're not at your peak, you're telling yourself, I'm committed to this and I'm not letting anything stand in my way. And that's powerful. Great things rarely happen overnight. You know, it's what's the quote? It takes a lifetime to be an overnight sensation. The overnight sensation tends to be the result of small, consistent actions over time, the 10,000 reps, if you like. Every time you show up, even when it's tough, you're laying another brick in the foundation of something great. And even, you know, showing up and being honest, like I'm being honest today, is other people will relate. So it's really about building that consistency and being there and showing up anyway. Consistency is what transforms average into exceptional. If Olympic athletes didn't show up for training because they didn't feel like it, you know, some of them show up when they're really, really feeling ill, but it's again about getting those reps in and really showing up to do it. One great example of this is many moons ago when video wasn't such a thing, there were online webinars, but they were audio webinars. And one way that Eben Pagan, who is a kind of marketing expert, who was one of the first really big marketing experts, he used to, at a low fee, record a whole course in one 10-hour sitting. And I'd signed up to attend because he liked to have an audience, so he didn't feel he was just recording into the ether. So he would go through all of the whole 10 hours. And I remember showing up for this 10-hour amazing training. And he was in California in the middle of an earthquake. So he was recording it from under the bed of his hotel room. And I was kind of blown away by his ability not just to show up in extraordinary circumstances, but to show up and deliver at like 110%. And that kind of that sticks in my mind when I think, you know, when I don't want to show up. So what can you do when you're not feeling like showing up? Here are a few tips that I find useful. Start small. Especially if you've got a big task and you don't feel like doing it, just choose the first part and just give yourself that little first part to do. Because once you actually start, sometimes it is just about getting started and you just flow into the rest of it. And if you're feeling overwhelmed, focusing on that small thing that you can accomplish gives you the energy to begin and then potentially to keep going once you've started. Remember your why. So if you're struggling to be motivated, reconnecting with the purpose in doing things. So for me, the purpose for me to do these videos is to support other people. So I'm hoping that is happening. Why did I start this in the first place? To get better at live streams, to become more consistent showing up, and to help as many people and serve as many people I can with my content. So remembering that helps me show up as well. Shift your perspective. The other thing that helps me show up is, as I say, my podcast is called Choosing Happy, and it's all about mental health and mental resilience for entrepreneurs and business owners and others. And it's really about that we always have a choice in every moment, and how we choose, you know, we can choose how we feel, we can choose what we're thinking, and we can shift our perspective in any moment. And remembering that helps me shift my perspective when I don't feel like showing up. So if you're thinking that you have nothing of value to contribute, sometimes your presence and effort are enough. And the other thing that I found is sometimes when I think I have nothing of value, what comes up is unconscious stuff, which is more valuable than some of the things I've planned to do. So you never know just who you might inspire or what great work may come out of showing up when you really don't want to. And at the same time, the final thing is be kind to yourself. Understand that it's okay not to be your best all the time, because we're all human, and give yourself permission to have an off day, but don't let that stop you from taking action. Perfection isn't the goal, progress is, and consistency is. So I want to leave you with this thought. Consistency is what turns dreams into reality. And it's not about always feeling motivated and showing up brilliantly. It's about showing up, doing the work, and trusting the process, even on days when you don't feel like it. Showing up can be a victory in itself. So if you're feeling out of sorts, uninspired, or just plain tired, show up anyway. Do what you can with what you have and where you are. And you've got this. So thanks for tuning in to this week's Friday Features. If this resonated with you, please do drop a comment below and let me know how you push through when you're not feeling your best. And if you're watching the replay, I'd like to hear from you too. So don't forget to share, follow, and subscribe for more content like this. And until next time, keep showing up and making progress, no matter how small it might seem. Have a magical weekend, and I will see you on Monday for Monday Motivation. Thanks for watching, and bye for now. Thank you so much for taking the time to listen to this week's episode. If you enjoyed it or think it would be valuable to others, please do share. And if you really enjoyed it, please leave me a review. It really helps the podcast. All of the links are in the show notes. And I look forward to seeing you next week on the Choosing Happy podcast.